As of the latest count, the number of firecracker-related injuries has risen to 52 with 5 amputations.
The Philippine military reminds its personnel against indiscriminate firing during the upcoming New Year celebration. AFP spokesperson Colonel Medel Aguilar says they have yet to receive reports of AFP personnel or soldiers involved in indiscriminate firing. But he asserts violators will face the appropriate punishment.
We have systems and procedure that will for the conduct of investigation, and if necessary, kung aakyat sa court martial, ito po ay ating papatupad. So meron po talagang meron ding pakaparusahan ang maganyang ganyang kasalanan, and yan po ay depende na rin po sa guilt na makikita ng ating mga investigators.
Other news, 9 Philippine communist rebels are killed by government troops in the province of Bukidnon. The military launched a Christmas Day offensive after the presence of New People's Army members were reported in the hinterlands of the provincial capital. The encounter occurred despite a unilateral ceasefire declared by the Communist Party of the Philippines. The armed forces dismissed the truce as a mere publicity stunt.
Ang nakalaban po ng ating pwersa dito ay yung mismong headquarters ng Sub-Regional Committee 2 ng North Central Mindanao Regional Committee. At siya po ang body count na nakuha natin. May 4 po na M16 na na-recover, kasama na rin po isang M203.
The development comes just weeks after both the government and the communist movement agreed to begin the process of restarting peace talks. Meanwhile, the Armed Forces welcomes proposals to build a permanent structure at Ayungin Shoal that's home to the country's lone military outpost in the West Philippine Sea. Now, this comes after Senator Sonny Angara confirmed reports Congress has allocated funds in the 2024 budget to construct a modern facility at the shoal. Currently, Philippine troops are staying at the BRP Sierra Madre. That's a worn-down warship deliberately run aground in the Second Thomas Shoal. The AFP says this kind of undertaking needs the support and cooperation of various government agencies. China has repeatedly blocked resupply missions to the outpost, which is located well within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone.
Siguro po pag paplanuhan pa yan, kasi it should be an interagency program, kasi ang na-mention po na structure is para siyang shelter para sa mga fisher folks, and therefore it will involve different government agencies. Now kami sa AFP will be ready to undertake or to perform our tasks that will be given in the implementation of that project.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says Manila is ready to move forward with oil exploration projects in the West Philippine Sea. Now, this is despite negotiations with China remaining in a deadlock. Marcos made that assurance in an interview with Japanese public broadcaster NHK. He said talks with China have made very little progress over the past 3 years. The chief executive maintains the area where the exploration is planned is within the maritime territory of the Philippines. In 2018, Manila and Beijing had agreed to jointly explore oil reserves and gas resources in the West Philippine Sea, particularly in Reed Bank. Several Philippine provinces now feeling the heat of the extended El Nino phenomenon. Weather Bureau Pagasa says 25 provinces are experiencing dry spells. It also says 2 unidentified provinces are seeing drought conditions. The government earlier said over 60 areas across the country could experience drought next year. But the agency says there are no reported damage to crops so far due to El Nino. It also assures the public government funding will be available to help farmers mitigate its impact.
Under the National El Nino Team, there will be, as we have mentioned, some conditional funds that will be available, as well as the quick response fund and also the existing MOOEs that will be available to all the national government or concerned agencies or members of the National El Nino Team. The goal of the National Action Plan for El Nino is to mitigate and address the impacts of this ongoing El Nino. So PAGASA provides all cross-cutting measures or mitigating measures so that we could address all the we could address all the objectives and the possible outcomes for different sectors concerned.
Philippine economic managers vow improved efforts next year to further accelerate economic growth. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan is quoted in state-run Philippine news agency as saying they will push for the passage of measures aimed at ensuring economic expansion. Balisacan says it will back bills that could create new jobs and uplift more from poverty. The Philippine economy expanded by 5.9% in the third quarter. This was a rebound from the lackluster 4.3% in the second quarter on slower government spending. Year-to-date, Balisacan says average growth is at 5.5%, which he says makes the Philippines among the top-performing economies in Asia. Next year, the economic team set a growth target range of 6.5 to 7.5%.
Ukrainians celebrate Christmas on December 25 for the first time. The country's main church agreed to move away this year from the traditional Julian calendar used in Russia, which celebrates Christmas on January 7. For many believers, observing the holiday on December 25 means distancing from Russia. When Moscow attacked Kyiv in February, Ukrainians began to reject the Russian language, culture, and their other historical ties. Floods inundate several provinces in southern Thailand after days of heavy rains. Floodwaters submerge roads, disrupting travel, and force residents to move their belongings to higher ground. The Army and Health Ministry have deployed assistance to flood-hit communities. Local authorities are also working with relevant agencies to drain the flooded areas.
Filipino boxer Marlon Tapales all set for a post-Christmas showdown with his Japanese foe Naoya Inoue. The 31-year-old looks to tame the monster Inoue in their super bantamweight fight happening this Tuesday evening in Tokyo. Longtime boxing analyst Ed Tolentino has said a win for Tapales will be historic. The victory would make him the first Filipino boxer to be an undisputed champion in the four-belt era in the sport. If successful, Tapales will also be the first two-handed loss to Inoue, believed to be one of the best pound-for-pound fighters in the world. Tapales is currently the holder of WBA-IBF bantamweight titles. He tells ABS-CBN News he's feeling hopeful of his prospects to bring home the title.